Claude 4 and Gemini 2.5 are here. I know everyone is like, is Gemini better or Claude is better? But my point is, why not both? The future will be more about AI orchestrations. At least this is the mindset you should have as a power AI user. You will never find an absolute winner in the AI space, and I still believe this from day one. Each AI model excels at different things. I have used both. From what I see, Gemini excels at scale and speed given its massive 1 to 2 million context window size, while Claude excels at strategy and storytelling, and its more attention to details with precise analysis. Both can code well, but they approach it differently. I find Gemini builds for functions, is fast, technical, data heavy, is good to build and implement prototypes quickly, while Claude emphasizes more for impact, strategic, buildable, and psychologically aware. So generally, I found the best way to use them is this. Let Gemini do the heavy lifting with its massive context window and multi-model power, handling datasets, analyzing multi-model inputs, creating initial analysis at scale. And then Claude becomes your strategic designer, transforming the raw analysis into precise insights, compelling narratives, and visually stunning output with its thoughtful reasoning. And here are some of the game-changing workflows where this approach deliver much better results with just one model. The first one is turning massive data into strategic dashboard with Claude's new memory upgrade. I love Claude's insight, but its context window limit is a headache for most people. So to overcome this, we can use Gemini 1 million context window, ask it to analyze super long documents, datasets, reports, and have Claude to turn them into actionable strategic intelligence while using its memory. So first, let me quickly show how to use memory on Claude. So on Claude Desktop, go to Settings. On the Developer, you can access the configuration file by clicking here. So I have added the memory MCP here with the path to the memory file. So this is where Claude will store and update the memory information. And it's now blank. And if everything's set up correctly, you will see the memory tool available on Claude. Okay, now let's say I'm doing the team priorities planning for the coming year. And so I want to make sure it is aligned with the overall company direction. So here is the company annual report. It's over 400 pages, full of text and graphics. And obviously for Claude, it can't index such a big file because of its contextual window limit. First, let's update Claude's memory about my role and the team's priorities, and it has been successfully updated. So now upload to Gemini and use this prompt to ask it to analyze the report and extract key insights in the specified areas, like financial, strategic initiative, and output as a very detailed report as we're gonna later pass to Claude for further analysis. So Gemini will initiate thinking and pull out a comprehensive summary with all the sections as we instructed, which is great. Now copy the response. On Claude, we're gonna set up a new project for the team planning, and we will use these custom instructions because we want to make sure it will access to tools like web search or memory that we set up before. Now paste the Gemini analysis here and then ask Claude to do the strategic analysis for the team. Note, we will ask it to use web search and memory in case it identifies any gaps or need to access extra information. So make sure you turn on the necessary tools before click submit. So you will see it might prompt you to access memory to retrieve more context about the project. And immediately, Claude will propose the team's strategic plan with the existing context, the additional research it did, and you can always cross-track the source Claude used, then comes up with competitor insights, opportunities, and the implication to the team's yearly planning. And they're all relevant to me. So this is what I always love using Claude about. Now we can further ask it to create two visualizations. One is the interactive dashboard for internal team sharing, and the second one is an action playbook for me as the team lead. Okay, so here is the dashboard, and I really like it. And this is also the reason why I stick with Claude for all kinds of visual storytelling. You will also notice the overall visual styling is upgraded in Claude 4 than the previous version. It's also following my color scheme instruction. Very clear. And then the strategic initiative for the team, also very easy to digest with the priority labels. And finally, with a risk opportunity map, which is very strategic to highlight immediately what are the high impact actions items for the team. And then also the action playbook to recap all the actions with timeline and metrics. So this is amazing. Another amazing thing is Claude will automatically update the memory without you telling it to do so. So in any chat, you can just ask it to retrieve the context for a particular project and it will pull for you. And unlike ChatGPT and Gemini's memory, which are more user-controlled, Claude 4 memory is more structured, autonomous, and agentic. And if you're thinking about using Claude more at work, there is a great resource from HubSpot I want to share with you, the complete guide to Claude AI. I've put the link in the description. It's free to download. So this guide is basically everything you need to know to get started using Claude in a workplace setting. It shows you how to set up Claude properly with projects, deep dive into the core features, and the best practices to implement Claude effectively in your organization. It also covers specific real situations where you can use Claude for work, like analyzing complex data, creating visualization for business intelligence, or use Claude as a personal assistant that manages your work priorities. These are all areas where Claude truly excels. What I like is how it provides ready-to-use commands to get started quickly, and you can always fine-tune it to fit into your workflow. Check it out in the description below, and thank you HubSpot for sponsoring this video. Alright, the next workflow is deep audience intelligence. So probably you have done audience research before, but sometimes it might still feel surface level. So we're gonna feed thousands of real customer reviews into Gemini for pattern analysis, and then have Claude dive into the psychology behind those patterns, so the persona will be much more high quality. For example, I'm doing audience research for a coffee shop business, so here I have collected a lot of real Google business reviews, YouTube comments about different popular coffee shops, so it's over a few thousands of them. Now attach all the review files, use this prompt to ask Gemini to analyze these reviews and comments and find patterns like customer preference, visiting behavior, and output it as a very detailed report so we can further do analysis on Claude. So Gemini combined all the reviews and do the analysis, and this is exactly what I want, a structured summary with data points and not high-level insights, like the key phrases used, grouped by common themes, peak hours patterns, complaint patterns, so these are all good initial analysis. Then copy the response. Now paste it on Claude and use this prompt to ask it to do sentiment analysis and create three distinct personas with their psychographics, coffee preference, decision making considerations. Then immediately Claude will come up three personas for our business, like the coffee connoisseur, who will pay premium, productive professionals, and a social experience seeker, and also the preferred messaging wordings. And I would say they are all making sense and a really good observation from Claude. Now the most exciting part is we will ask Claude to build a persona dashboard for these profiles and make it actionable for the coffee shop operations and marketing decision. So in a minute, we have the persona cards that are ready to share, highlighting the key characteristic, product preference, marketing approach, and these cards will be so useful for your messaging development, campaign targeting, and your teammates can always reference from. So that's why this is always one of my favorite ways to use AI. And I highly encourage you to try this so you can develop more targeted marketing message for your ideal audience. The next, AI-powered speaking coaching. Speaking and presentation is a big piece in any professional setting. Even though your content is solid, your delivery, pacing may still need to improve. Like people often say, I speak too fast. So we can have Gemini to analyze your speaking or presentation patterns and Claude to rewrite your script with its professional writing. And more than that, we can generate a native audio using Gemini. For example, I want to improve my presentation skills or delivery for any professional settings. So first, on Google AI Studio, access the latest Gemini 2.5, make sure to turn on thinking mode. So here we can upload any video files, perhaps your presentations, demo, audio, or attach YouTube video. So let's say I have this video about AI prompting, so import it to Gemini, and now I can ask it to analyze all the delivery problems, pronunciations, and areas of improvement for me. And you can see this is really the multimodal power of Gemini. It can analyze all the issues I have in the video, like pacing, unclear transition, pronunciations. So this is so useful if you have presentation you want to get feedback on, or any talks for your learning purpose. Now we're gonna copy the response and save it. So go back to Claude, make sure to turn on thinking, attach both the video analysis done by Gemini and the original script. Because Claude 4 is really good at writing, so we will ask it to repurpose this video into a shorter training video version, but to also address all the issues Gemini has identified. And what's more is to also ask it to generate a set of voice style instructions to be used in Gemini. So you can see this is amazing. I like how Claude 4 really mimics my tone so right. It doesn't feel robotic, and it has explicitly added the pause marker and pacing instruction, as I always speak so fast. So this is great, and you can see feeding Claude with Gemini analysis will make a whole difference here for the script. The voice style instruction is also very detailed, like pacing, pause pattern, energy progression, and even the pitch variation. So this is absolutely crazy. And I can say Claude really excels in creating all these of communication guidelines. And again, copy all the responses. Now the most powerful thing is we can use Gemini to generate the audio with one click. On AI Studio, click the native speech generation. So it even supports generating a multi-speaker audio. But for this case, we'll just pick the single speaker option. Then pick a voice that you like. Now paste the voice style instruction generated by Claude here, and also paste the full script here, and click run. So after a while, the audio file is ready and is within 5 minutes.
There are lots of perfect prompt formulas out there, and I'm sure you've heard of them before.
So you can hear that Gemini new native audio is much more natural and with emotions as well. And I have listened to full audio. It follows the instruction to add pause, have pitch variation. So this is absolutely incredible. There are so many ways you can use this workflow, like your internal training materials, content repurposing, and even if you just want to learn speaking and have Gemini to generate the correct version for your own practice. The next one is building your presentation visual system. One of the things that I constantly praise about Claude is the strategic visual storytelling, and it's one of my favorite ways to use it. So we can double down to build a system creating those high quality visuals, strategic charts, similar to those top consulting firms on demand. And this is now possible using Gemini and Claude. So first we can collect different consulting decks like from McKinsey, BCG as a learning source for Gemini. Collect as much as you can to fully utilize Gemini big context window, especially those that have lots of charts, infographics, visual storytelling, and then attach all the sample decks to Gemini and use this prompt to ask it to analyze all the decks and identify the best practice for presentation visualization, like the most effective chart types by purpose, visual design patterns, storytelling techniques, and output as a detailed report. So the initial analysis is really good. Gemini breaks down details for each scenario with the most appropriate chart types, examples, visual design patterns. So this is so detailed. So copy the response. Then on Claude, we can create a new project specifically for generating beautiful presentation visuals. Now paste the Gemini's analysis, and also I will attach this Claude visual storytelling guide as reference on my brand tone. And use this prompt to ask it to create a playbook for the presentation visuals and generate sets of custom instructions for different presentation scenarios. So quickly, Claude will come up a set of visualization playbook that is ready to use. And I really like it. It's super detailed, covering the most common types of visual needs with specific instructions, with optimal color tone, and then the quality checkpoints. So this is excellent. Now we can just click copy to project, and it will immediately be imported to this project that is ready to use. So first, let's try generate a basic dashboard visual. So I have this market data about the child education market. Now ask Claude to generate the visual to be used to present to executives. So you can see this is great. It's using the brand color tone, it's beautifully designed with the appropriate chart we set from the instruction. And the best thing is you can now use the system to generate all kinds of key visualization for your projects or presentation or share with your team. We are not done yet, so let's also build an infographic, because this is what makes Claude truly different from other AI models. Again, I have this market data. This time it's about healthcare market. So give it to Claude and ask it to generate a one-page visually stunning infographic to summarize the market opportunities. So you can see this is Claude's power to make strategic visual official like this, and it's following all the best practice learned from those big consulting firms. And you can always further enhance it on Figma to make it even better. And so immediately we have this ready to use visual for our presentation, and it will make the whole difference for your deck. It looks professional and decent. And I have also tried the same prompt and instruction on Gemini. So you can see, although the one from Gemini is not bad, it's also beautifully designed, but it's more factual. And so Claude's infographics are always more strategic and tell the story a bit better. Now here is the most powerful way of using both. It's not just have them collaborate with each other, but also critique each other's work. So we're gonna have Gemini to create the initial version, then Claude become the critic, analyzing what Gemini missed and enhance it further with its reasoning. So you would always get the best possible results. For example, I'm a product manager at an SEO software company, and I'm redesigning the keyword explorer function. And I know SEO ranking is always being praised for its good UX design. So I have gathered different materials about the tool, the screen cap of the interface, videos about the feature, blog articles, and then I can feed them all to Gemini and ask it to analyze and recreate a functional dashboard based on the best practices it identified. And what I like about Gemini is the speed. So you can see it can quickly recreate the full dashboard and also summarize the best practice findings in what makes SEO ranking approach effective. And then for the dashboard, it's also following a similar style, applying the good practices with all the key sections like search volume, keyword ideas, and it's also functional with demo data. And so this is already a good version, but we're gonna pass it to Claude for further enhancement. Now copy all the codes, save it as a separate file. So on Claude, we're gonna rebuild the dashboard again, but make sure you use Sonic 4, as I found Opus 4 will hit the usage limit really fast. So attach both the original dashboard design and the Gemini's recreation codes and ask it to compare them side by side and critique Gemini's work and what it has missed. So this is a really powerful way of using Claude 4, because instead of building it from scratch with burns or token fast, you can ask Claude to analyze Gemini's first draft and make meaningful recommendation. And I really like the suggestions. What are the areas Gemini is missing the mark, like visual design gaps, data presentation, and Claude is super good at applying UX principle. Now use this prompt to ask it to build an enhanced dashboard that beats both versions. So not just making it look good, but also user-friendly. So quickly, Claude returns a mockup, and I found some chart lines are missing, so we can ask it to add it back, and this is much better. And it's also functional like Gemini's one. And you can tell it's not just based on Gemini's and SEO ranking version, but also Claude has made improvement on top, adding the export function, like the keyword idea section. It adds different trend icons, make everything shortable, adding more data columns, so making it more useful to the end user. So you can see that although it looks similar, you can definitely tell Claude's strength to be more attentive to details and more thoughtful in its output. So stop asking which AI is the best and start asking which AI is better for this step. I encourage you to join my community. You will get access to all my prompts I share on my channel and other featured content. You can find the link in the description to join. And before you go, I also highly encourage you to watch this video about Claude and MCP, because MCP will be a big piece in AI agents development, and you don't want to miss it. I will see you next time.